Episode 1545, recording day 50868, take one.
CBS presents this program in color.
To Tell the Truth is proud to present Miss Hedy Lamarr.
And I'm here and proud to present my son, Anthony Loder.
Is this actor Anthony Loder? Is this Anthony Loder? Or is this Hedy Lamarr's son, Anthony Loder? Well, we'll soon find out as they try to fool this panel. Bert Convy, sitting in for Peggy Cass, Phyllis Newman, Orson Bean, Kitty Carlisle, plus 100 of the people in our studio audience on To Tell the Truth. This portion of the Tell the Truth is brought to you by soothing pink Pepto-Bismol liquid for upset stomach.
Absent, absent, absent. Why, half the class is absent.
I bet they got the bug.
When the bug hits below the belt, take Pepto-Bismol liquid. It won't kill the bug, but it will make the bug easier to live with. Because Pepto-Bismol's coating action soothes nausea and relieves distress in the lower tract.
The bug.
When the bug starts bugging you, remember soothing pink Pepto-Bismol liquid.
Is that the way you clean your bathroom? Try new fantastic disinfectant spray cleaner. The new aerosol from Texize. No foam, no rinsing. It cleans and disinfects like that. Look how easily it removes stains and mildew between the tiles. Fantastic cleans most anything. Fantastic disinfectant spray cleaner. It's new.
And now, here's our host on To Tell the Truth, Bud Collier.
Thank you very much. Welcome once again to Tell the Truth. Good afternoon, panel.
Good afternoon, Bud.
Hedy Lamarr started her acting career in Vienna with the great Max Reinhardt. And now her son is embarking on his own career as an actor. So let's start the first part of our game with Kitty Carlisle.
Thank you, Bud. Hedy, it's good to see you. Welcome.
Thank you.
What is your son doing now?
He's still in acting school as well as trying out for movie roles as well as stage plays.
Bert Convy.
Yes, thank you, Bud. Mr. Lamarr, what kind of advice did you give your son when he started off on this career?
Advice? I hardly give advice. I give suggestions.
Well, let's make it a suggestion then.
Well, not to be an actor, for one thing.
Phyllis Newman.
Mr. Lamarr, has he always wanted to be an actor since he's been a child?
Me?
No, your son.
My son? I think he was a ham all his life.
Was he? Yes. Thank you.
Orson.
You're beautiful.
Thank you.
Do you feel that your son will be helped or hurt by being your son in the trade? How much of each?
No, I think he has a character of his own.
All right.
Kitty.
Is he married?
Yes.
Bert.
So he's studying theater in school then, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Very serious about it.
Where does he go to school?
Right now he's in acting school only.
In New York. Do you know who he's studying
with? Phyllis.
I was going to ask, who is he studying with? Who is he studying acting with?
Yeah. Well, it varies. Maybe he'll tell you.
I see.
What do you hope for him? Let me ask this. What do you think he hopes for himself? A stage career primarily, or a movie career primarily, or what?
Just to be a success.
Just to be a success, all right.
Kitty.
How did you discourage him from being an actor? It didn't work, obviously, but what did you do?
I told him it's by far not the easiest job in the world, and he didn't take my suggestion.
Bert Convy.
Yes, does he have an idol by any chance, someone that he would like to emulate, do you think?
You mean as a man actor, yes, as Gregory Peck or Marlon Brando? Yes, he likes good acting.
Has he has he had to take a lot of jobs to other kinds of jobs while he's been studying acting?
He does take most any part he can get a hold of.
No, I mean other kinds of jobs besides acting.
Well, that's all we have time for this preliminary questioning. I'm sorry to say you've learned a little something from Hedy Lamarr about her son, Anthony Loader. Let's ask the gentlemen now to please come in from their soundproof room. All right, panel, see if you can find out which of these young men is Anthony Loader. We'll start the questioning with Bert Conley. Bert?
Thank you, Bud. Number two, did your mother ever give you any advice?
Yes, she does.
What kind of career advice did she give you?
Well, career advice just told me simply to do the things I want to do as well as I possibly could do it and not look to use her name, her reputation in achieving that.
Yes, number three, I think it's courageous of you, you know, to use your name, not her name. I think that's good. Do you think it will be a help or a hindrance to you to have a famous mother?
I don't think it would matter much.
You don't think it will matter either way?
No, it's...
Number one, who are you studying acting with?
Wynne Hammond.
Thank you.
Phyllis Newman.
Thank you. Number three, did you have a special pet name for your mother when you were a child? Did you call her anything else but Mummy?
Mom.
Mom. Oh, that's unusual. Yes. Number two, did you?
Well, we used to joke, call her Hedy Lamarr, the movie star.
Oh, really? She must have hit you for that. Yes. Number one, what other kinds of jobs have you had to take while you've been studying acting?
Well, I've actually just been studying, and I worked at Bloomingdale's in the sales department over Christmas time.
I see. And number.
Orson B.
Number three, do you study with Wynne Hammond too?
Yes, I do.
He's only the best acting teacher in the business.
Right.
It's very good.
All right. Number two, now, your mother is the personification of loveliness. Now, you're married, right?
Yes, I am.
Before you were married, when you went out with girls and they found out your mother was Hedy Lamarr, did it make them feel ill at ease?
They're a little bit scared.
Yeah? Number one, what was the reaction of girls before you settled down with your...
They were very impressed, you know, that my mother was Hedy Lamarr.
Yeah?
They,
Kitty.
Number three, did they always want him? Do you think that the girls really went out with you to get to meet your mother?
Maybe at first.
But later on, you felt they loved you for yourself. Number one, do you think that having, and indeed you have had two famous parents, do you think that having two famous parents is a help or a hindrance, not necessarily in the acting world, but to a young person growing up in any field?
Well, my mother was always very close to us, and I don't think it was, no.
You don't think it
was? She always took care of us, no.
That's it. Time for you to mark your ballots, if you will, please, now, panel, without change or consultation. Mark them, and while you're voting, it's time for our studio audience to vote. Audience, when I say vote, please select number one, number two, or number three. Are you ready? Vote. All right, let's find out how our panelists voted. Bert, for whom did you vote?
Well, I don't think it's number three. I think it's number two. He is confident, and he knew what he called his mother when she was a child. But number one bears a resemblance around the mouth. And if he's not her son, well, then he should be.
Phyllis.
Well, I voted for number one also for purely the reasons of a look, a great thing that comes out of him, that comes out of Miss Lamarr, too.
Orson.
I think it's number three. You're all crazy.
Kitty.
Well, I voted for number one for two reasons. First, I think he looks like both his parents. In second place, I think that it's very typical and right that a young person studying acting should either work at Bloomingdale's or Macy's or something at Christmas, because they all do.
And strong.
Be kind to the fellow in the tie department. He's liable to be a movie star.
Very well. Let's find out who got the most votes from our studio audience. Our audience voted for number two. Hedy, will you go over and show us which one is your fine son, Anthony Loader? Oh, thank you very much. Very much indeed. Hetty, I gather from the questioning earlier that you weren't really 100% in favor of Anthony becoming an actor. Is that right?
That's right.
But he's gone ahead in spite of...
Yeah, he'll make it, I
guess. Well, that's nice.
Made up his mind to it. I didn't.
Well, good luck to both of you, and
thank you.
You certainly graced our show, and thank you, Hetty, very much. Number one, what is your real name, and what do you really do?
Fred Von Myers. I'm a student at New York University, and I work in advertising on the side.
Thank you. And number two, what is your real name, and what do you do?
My name is John Dupre, and I'm an advertising executive here in New York City.
Well, in checking the score, we find that you did very well. 1, 2, 3, 4 incorrect votes. 4 times $100 is $400, gentlemen. Thanks for being with us. Thank you, Hetty. Goodbye, and God bless you. Now, panel, Anthony Loader has just been married just about a year, so we'll meet his pretty bride in just a minute.
It was our first anniversary. 1 week. So, I bought a present for her. And one for me. Honey, I said, your cooking's sensational. But I wish you'd use Maxwell House coffee. Blue can, good to the last drop, Maxwell House. I knew little Maxwell housewife loved it. So, I asked what else I could do. Know what she said? The dishes.
Maxwell House coffee, ground and instant.
SOS has longer lasting soap, but longer lasting than, say, this one? Dunk them both and come out squeezing. May the best pad win. Together, squeeze. Any soap left? Dunk again. Wanna bet who's gonna win? SOS still has plenty of soap. The other pad is washed out. SOS has longer lasting soap than any other steel wool pad.
And now, let's meet Anthony Loader's bride.
What is your name, please?
My name is Roxanne Loader.
My name is Roxanne Loader.
My name is Roxanne Loader.
We'll be back to play our game with Roxanne and Anthony Loader after this word.
Harvey loves spaghetti. He says he can tell the difference between homemade sauce that simmered a full 4 hours and French's spaghetti sauce mix that took only 15 minutes.
Very good.
Harvey said he could tell the difference. It's not easy. Try French's Italian or new mild family style spaghetti sauce mix.
If you've ever had potatoes in the country, you know how different they tasted. Now you can get all the creamy goodness and robust flavor of country-style mashed potatoes from French's country-style mashed potatoes in minutes. And you don't have to go to the country.
This portion of To Tell the Truth was brought to you by Soothing Pink Pepto-Bismol Liquid for upset stomach. The next portion of To Tell the Truth is brought to you by Dow Bathroom Cleaner, the aerosol cleaner that lifts dirt off without scouring.
Very well, panel. Since you've already questioned Anthony Loader as Hetty Lamar's son, I'm going to give you just a short time to question him as Roxanne Loader's husband. Let's start with Phyllis Newman. Phyllis?
Thank you. Anthony, how did you meet Roxanne?
Through a friend. It was a blind date.
Love at first sight?
Very first sight.
Okay.
What does she do in the kitchen? Does she scrub out the grease traps, clean out Germ City? What is she? Is she any good?
In the whole house and the kitchen and great cook.
Spotless, great.
Kitty.
Marvelous. Is she going to be an actress?
No.
Goody.
Bert.
Oh, then she's not an actress. What was she when you met her?
A student at Cooper Union.
Phyllis.
Art school.
Where were you married?
We were married at her house out in the country, outside on a lake. Very nice.
Orson.
How long have you been married?
Since June 3rd.
Oh, my goodness. And they said it would never last.
Kitty.
Is she prepared to support you if you can't, you know, make ends meet as an actor, which sometimes happens in the beginning?
She is helping. She's helping.
All right, that's all the time we have for this little questioning. Got a little something about Anthony Loader and his wife, Roxanne. Let's ask the ladies now to come in from the soundproofed room. Very well, panel. See if you can find out which of these ladies is married to Anthony Loader. We'll start the questioning with Orson Bean. Orson?
Thank you. Number two. Now, he tells me that you run a tight ship. Now, the spotless kitchen and a good cook. What do you cook best?
I have a chicken recipe that I like.
Yeah, that sounds good. Number three. Now, what kind of a career do you hope that he'll have? What would you like for him to do?
I'd like for him to do theater. Anything he's happy in.
Theater more than movies, you think?
Both.
Yeah? Number one, now, what's the worst thing about this fellow here? We can see he's a fine, handsome-looking fellow here. What does he do to drive you up the wall? Everybody has something.
Probably he leaves his socks around.
He leaves his socks all over the place.
Kitty.
Goodness, you are neat if that bothers you. Number three, have you ever or do you intend to be financially helpful in terms of working if he can't get a job or if he has to be studying or something?
I'm working right now. I have a job. We both work.
Number two, what is your job?
I work for the illustrator, James McMullen.
Uh-huh. And number one, was it love at first sight on your part?
I think it was.
Thank you. Number two, did you know who he was?
Not for a long
time. Bert Convy.
Number two, you didn't know that he was Hedy Lamarr's son, is that right?
No, I didn't.
Did it make any difference when you found out?
Not really.
Number one, you've just been married a short time. What was your first fight about? Do you remember your first big fight? Number two remembers, I can tell. Do you remember number two? Number three,
yeah.
Do you remember your first fight?
It was private.
It was private. That's what I was driving at.
Phyllis.
Thank you. Number one, do you remember the name of the friend who first introduced the two of you?
Yes.
Could you tell me? Would you not like to tell me?
I don't want to say.
Oh, all right. Number three, would you like to tell me?
Mike Kidden.
Mike Kidden. Number two, when did you first meet your husband's mother?
At our wedding.
At your wedding, were you frightened?
Not at all.
Not at all? Number three.
That's it. Time for you now to mark your ballot, so please do so. And audience, when I say vote again, please select number one, number two, or number three. Are you ready? Vote. Very well. Let's see how our panel voted. All marked. Bert, for whom did you vote?
Number three knew all the answers. She's very fast. She remembered what the first fight was about, wouldn't tell me. But you see the tie that... Anthony is wearing is hip, and number two is dressed very hippish like, and she looks like an artist to me. I don't know. I think it's number two for all those reasons.
Phyllis,
I have a bizarre reasoning. If you've got a few minutes,
yeah.
Yes. Number one and number three are both dark beauties, very much on the tradition of Anthony's mother. So I voted for number two, feeling that a son. Goes to the op. I don't know. Number two. Forget the whole thing.
Orson.
I voted for number two. She's a fine little chicken. And I can see her down on her hands and knees, scrubbing up the linoleum and making somebody a good wife.
The worst answer I've ever heard.
Nothing has changed.
Kitty. I voted for number three because she does indeed look a little bit like Hedy Lamarr, and I feel that sons do very often try to tend toward because it's a form of admiration.
Yes.
And also, she's very efficient, and I think she's the kind of woman who could be a helpmeet to a man.
Helpmeet?
Is it a helpmeet? It's a
helpmeet. We have to
pause our phone. All right, we'll find out how our audience voted Meet the Real Roxanne Loader in just 60 seconds.
It's dirt shaking. Dirt shaking. Dow bathroom cleaner is dirt shaking.
Dow lifts the dirt off.
No scouring needed. Chrome gleams.
Dow lifts the dirt off.
So tile breaks out in shine. No scratch, just shine in one wipe time.
Dow lifts the dirt off.
like no scouring cleanser ever could. So even dirtiest bathtub rings wipe clean. No grits left behind. Dow sanitizes and lifts the dirt off. It's dirt shaking.
So let's see who got the most votes from our studio audience. Our audience voted for number three. Very well, Anthony, will you show us which one is indeed your lovely wife? Thank you. You may be seated. Number one, what is your real name and what do you really do?
I'm Penny Donahue, and I'm publicity representative for the Everything Card.
And number three, what is your real name and what do you do?
My name is Denise Colton, and I'm married to a professional baseball player.
Now, wait a minute. Anthony, why did you kiss number three?
Because she's my lovely sister.
Denise Colton, formerly Denise Loader, is now married to Larry Colton, who was a pitcher for the Philadelphia Phillies. Hey, hey. How about bringing Larry on the show someday?
I'd love to.
Well, we'll set that thing in the works right away. Checking the score briefly, we find that there were two incorrect votes. That's twice $100. Or $200, and I don't think we should say goodbye without asking Hetty, if she will, to come out and join us in a family portrait. I think that would be nice. There we have mother, daughter, son, and daughter-in-law. Hetty, you must indeed be proud of all of them, aren't you?
Oh, yes.
And it's quite obvious that they're very proud of you. Thanks for being on our show, and thank you, too, for being on our show. And I hope you enjoyed it. Goodbye, and God bless you. We'll return to our show in 1 minute.
Irregularity. Were you born that way, or is your system different? Some people think normal means daily regularity, so they take a laxative every day. But doctors say normal is what's normal for you. And one of the best ways to help find out what's normal for you is with X-Lax. X-Lax doesn't try to prevent irregularity, just relieve it. That's how X-Lax helps you toward your normal regularity, the way your system is, however age has changed it. If you take a laxative every day, try X-Lax for a while, but only when you really need it. Famous chocolated X-Lax, or now, for people who prefer an unflavored laxative, there's an X-Lax pill you just swallow with water. Try it.
This portion of the Tell the Truth is brought to you by Dow Bathroom Cleaner, the aerosol cleaner that lifts dirt off without scouring. To Tell the Truth is a Mark Woodson, Bill Todman production. This is Johnny Olson speaking. The program is recorded.